Hi everyone. One of the very commonly asked questions in engineering exams, whether it is for DEC or engineers, is the difference between fixed pitch propellers and controllable pitch propellers. So today I thought I will show you the difference between both the propellers by using the diagrams and by providing the answers to you guys so that you can use the notes from this video to provide the answers in the exam. So fixed pitch propellers, let's start with that first. So the propeller blades of a fixed pitch propeller, they have a fixed position, as the term itself explains. So as a consequence of the fixed position, the direction of rotation of the propeller has to change if the ship stops or if it goes astern. This is realized with a reversing clutch or a reversible engine. A reversing clutch and therefore also the fixed pitch propeller is economical in ships, say up to about 1250 kilowatt to 1300 kilowatts. The diameter of fixed pitch propellers varies between 25 centimeters and 12 meters, depending on, of course, the size of the ship and the purpose for which the propeller is built. The choice of a fixed or a controllable pitch propeller depends on, among other things, the need for a shaft generator and the need for easy maneuvering qualities. What you see on your screens here is the installation of a fixed right-handed propeller with shaft. The advantages of a fixed propeller over a controllable pitch propeller are that they are less vulnerable to damage. The propeller does not revolve when berthing, so it imposes less danger to mooring boats and there is less risk of ropes getting entangled in the propeller. The disadvantages of the fixed propeller over a controllable pitch propeller are that in adverse weather conditions, the propeller may turn with too many RPM or revolutions per minute, which can hamper the propulsion. Fixed propellers also have a limited range of RPM for maneuvering and so with the power range. Let's talk about controllable pitch propellers. Now what you see on your screen is a controllable pitch propeller. So the blades of this type of a propeller can be turned around the blade axis, thereby changing the propeller pitch. These propellers are internally complicated. The mechanism that adjusts the propeller pitch is located in the boss of the propeller. It is activated from the engine room and remotely controlled from the bridge by a hydraulic cylinder. So have a look at this diagram and I'll tell you what each one of them is. So number one, of course, in this diagram is the propeller blade. Number two is the boss, or it's also called the hub. Number three, what you see is the watertight or oil-tight seal between the shaft and the propeller. Number four is the stern frame. Number five is the propeller shaft. And number six is the stern tube. As I go ahead in this video, I'll show you the other parts as well. So you see, the most striking feature of the controllable pitch propeller is that it only rotates in one direction, making the reversing clutch or the reversible engine unnecessary. Unlike the fixed pitch propeller, the controllable pitch propeller is an integrated part of the propulsion system. This makes it possible that power and necessary propulsive forces can all be controlled by simply changing the position of the blades. So that you can see here, you can see how the cross sections of a propeller blade and the forces that act on the part of the rotating propeller blade is being shown here. So you can see the cross sections and forces when the ship is going ahead. All the vectors are pointing backwards. The ship is going forward. Now the blades are rotated towards the zero position. This means that the propulsive forces above and below the equal, or they are equal in magnitude, but opposite in direction. The net propulsive force is zero, but the propeller still absorbs a large amount of energy that is converted to turbulence of the wake. To go astern, the blades are rotated even further, resulting in a forward propulsive force. The position of the blades can be changed manually without the loss of propulsive force in controllable pitch propellers. If the hydraulic system fails, the blades can be locked in the ahead position. The advantages of a controllable pitch propeller is that it can propel the ship at all speeds, even at very low speed without stopping the engine. It can change quickly from ahead to astern and vice versa. It has improved efficiency on ships with changing power demand like tugboats or fishing crafts. And it can easily be combined with a shaft generator. It can stop a ship with maximum power, and in case of propeller damage, changing a blade is sometimes possible afloat depending on the ship's trim and the type possibilities, of course. Here you can see is the shaft generator is fitted, which can also work as an electric motor with power supply from the auxiliary diesel generators. The electric motor can produce propulsion power in case of major main engine problems for emergency propulsion. A shaft generator can produce electric power also during maneuvering, which is an economical advantage. The classification society does not require this system or the maximum speed it can obtain. The system is sometimes used on small ships. Controllable pitch propeller systems, however, are very vulnerable to the hydraulic components and many sealing rings. A damaged sealing ring can result in oil pollution. What you see on your screen here is the shaft generator that can supply the electric power on a ship as long as the main engine keeps running. With controllable pitch propellers, the generator frequency can be kept constant because the RPM of the engine remains constant. The engine drives the shaft generator via the reduction gearbox. So on your screens, what you see here, again, I'm showing you is number 5 is the propeller shaft. Number 7, let's say, is the intermediate shaft to the engine shaft. It goes towards the engine. Number 8, what you see is the reduction gearbox that I just mentioned. Number 9 is the mechanically driven lubricating oil pump. Number 10, you can see, is the collar shaft or the thrust. Number 11 is the actuating motor. Alright, so these are the parts of the controllable pitch propellers as driven by the shaft generator. So I hope you understood the difference between controllable pitch propellers and the fixed pitch propellers. And you can provide the answers in terms of advantages and disadvantages for each in the exam. What you see on your screen here is a drawing of a controllable pitch propeller with a propeller shaft. The pitch adjustment of the blades is done via oil pressure through the hollow shaft. The figures apply to a propeller with diameter of about 2.5 meters only. In future, I will make more videos on the propulsion system of vessels, because a basic knowledge of the propulsion system is required by deck officers, and of course, an advanced knowledge is required by engineers. However, this forms a foundation knowledge for both the officers. Thank you for watching the video, guys, and all the best with your studies. Bye for now.